That's why I learned from Kapaski, Kapaski, Kappa, Kat, oh my. PCIe times 4.2. Big memory, fast processing. Easy. Thank you, Ba. Oh, he just hung out with me. Hi, HusKKiee here. I'm a professional shoutcaster, and today I will be doing an unboxing and review on a product that the producer has specifically told me to not do research on. Why do you ask? Because I am really good when it comes to technology, specifically when it comes to using them. And I hope that today I will be able to learn something new. Without any further ado, let's get into the review and unboxing. So when I was young, my dad used to run a cyber cafe, and he always dreamed of me taking over the IT business one day. But me being the obedient kid that I am, disobeyed his wishes. Today I'm a professional guy who screams at a monitor or screen. Here we have the motherboard that I am holding for the first time. Look at this thing, huh? GIGABYTE, yeah, GIGA for sure. Humongous, ginormous.
Humongous, ginormous.
So you know the feeling of buying a new boat and there's a good smell to it? It's the same thing as buying something when it comes to technology. You know, unboxing a new phone, unboxing a new computer part. So we have this motherboard. Look at this. Look at this thing. Oh, the GIGABYTE Z590i motherboard. Look at this. You guys have the privilege of looking at this firsthand. This is the front view. It's the back view. Look at this. Pretty as always. This makes you want to just get to know the thing more. Right? Right, so I have a list in front of me, and this is a list about all the awesome things that this motherboard brings to the table. So first of all, this thing is designed for small form factor mini ITX build. And then I'm told that I will be a quiz. I'm about to show them how smart I am.
Alright, your first question is, what does ITX stand for? Information Technology Extended, Intelligent Technology Express, or Incredibly Tiny Exoskeleton?
Judging from all those three choices, I would say the second choice describes me, super intelligent, and therefore I know the answer is the third one. Very small exoskeleton.
You are wrong.
Dang.
The correct answer is actually A, Information Technology Extended.
Man, since when they become less fancy with those acronyms, I was expecting something more luxurious. So the second one is that this thing, this baby right here, features an LGA 1200 socket. Oh, that sounds very nice and sexy. I like it.
So, can you show us where the LGA 1200 socket is?
Let me look for a socket. I got this. So 1200 is a big number, right? I just gotta look for a cluster of sockets. So here we go. This right here. Looks 1200 to me. I get it?
No.
This one. Third time's a charm. Hold on. This one. I tried. Yeah, my producers are shaking their heads.
The LGA 1200 socket is actually the square in the center where you put your processor.
This thing?
Yes.
I got cheated. Install processor first, then remove and keep. They put a cap at it. That's not how you hide the answers. Come on.
What kind of processor can the LGA 1200 socket support? A, Intel 10 and 11 Gen. B, AMD Ryzen 4th and 5th Gen. And C, Intel 4th and 5th Gen.
I'm gonna go with, I know it's definitely not B, A, 10 and 11.
You are right.
See, that's a charm. I got this, boys. We got this in the bag. So this thing has two, not one, not three, two. Three minus one. Two RAM slots. It support a dual channel DDR4 memory up to 64 GB.
Okay, now can you show us where the RAM slots are?
This one's easy. Like jet players always say, watch this. I actually can't see the front, this thing.
You're correct.
This is the first thing I learned, RAM, which is something memory. I
You know what RAM stands for? A. Rigid Array Memory. B. Random Access Memory. C. Real-Time Accelerator
B. Memory. Random Access Memory. My primary school knowledge. Still here. Random access memory. That was very random, actually. I randomly accessed my memory for the random access memory.
You know what the RAM does?
Okay, this... I can't get the words out of my head. Please help me. Mom, Pa, Pa. See, father, it's not picking up. Okay, Pa, 我在一个 video shoot, and then 我有一个 question, 一个问题关于 computer 的。 关于 motherboard 了，我要问下你 ，OK？ 那个 RAM 啊是做什么的？RAM越大，你的
computer 的 memory 越快，processing 越快。
OK，OK， thank you. Yeah, hear that? Big memory, fast processing, easy. Thank you, Pa. Oh, he just hung out with me. So number four is that this thing supports Intel Wi-Fi 6 and Intel 2.5 GBE LAN. So. A lot of Intel right there, I know, but they all sound awesome to me. They all sound awesome.
So, you know what I'm going to ask you?
I wish I do, but no, I don't.
Can you show me where the LAN port is?
LAN port, alright. This is probably going to be the easiest question, right? Hold on. They say if you take more than 5 seconds to find the answer, you're probably inexperienced. Everyone watching this, please do not flame me. Wait, is there even a LAN port? Hold on. This looks like one. See this thing? Sure, it's this, right? No? Yes, just lie. Is it this thing? Still no?
Do you want a hint?
Do I want a hint? Yes, yes, please.
It sits on the side.
Oh! See, my hand has been covering it this entire time. Ta-da! That's the LAN port.
Which of the following is not a feature of Wi-Fi 6? A. Faster speeds. B. Better performance in congested areas. Or C. Built-in virus protection.
Because it's pretty weird that Wi-Fi would have built-in virus protection because that's where all the viruses are, right? That's what I learned from Kapaski. Never mind. This thing has a dual NVMe PCIe times 4.2 connectors with included heatsink.
Alright, can you point out where they are?
Today, I was expecting one. Okay, hold on. So I was fortunate enough to be provided some guidance throughout this whole thing. I'm about to show you guys the one thing I know, the one thing that sounds fancy, and I know where it is. The heat sink. This thing. No? We need to start labeling this stuff. Old people like me, we can't find things. Is it this thing? It's definitely not dual, but... Is it this thing? Yeah, I knew it. Can I get a hint?
They are hidden underneath something.
Underneath the heat sink? By the end of this, I think I will need some glasses. This thing is a heat sink. Oh, there we go. Please tell me there's something in here. Yes, see, didn't take me long. 5 seconds. 5 seconds is all I need. They tell me heat sink, I'll be like, yeah, right there.
That's not the one.
What?
What does the heat sink do? Well, A. Maximize surface area to improve heat dissipation. B. Allows the heat to sink to the bottom of the device. C. Accumulates heat and converts it to a secondary power source.
One of those trick questions. I'm about to go with B. That's where the heat sinks to because it's called a heat sink. Please tell me it's correct. They name it heat sink, so it's B. That's where the heat goes.
A. Maximize surface area to improve heat dissipation.
That's not it. Sink, that's a cop.
So, how well do you think you did?
Pretty okay, I think, for the first time. No, of course I did awesome. Terrific, you know. I got my blood from my dad. My dad, proud of me on the phone, he hung up. He's like, son, you got this. So yes, I did great. That's it for the unboxing, a review, quiz and a test of my intelligence. And I hope you guys enjoy this. And if you guys still don't know what this is, here you go. This is the GIGABYTE Z590i Vision D motherboard. Sleek, small, intelligent, sturdy exoskeleton, and a lot more awesome stuff. And with that being said, if you guys are interested in this, or getting your hands on one, do check out the links in the description below. This is HusKKiee signing off. I'll see you guys in the next one.